Good morning and welcome to this week's Wednesday in the Wetlands. Today I want to talk to you about data lakes, or as I think when I get up close to most organizations, data lakes, data swamps, except that's offensive. A swamp is a colloquial term for most people with negative connotations, and in reality, wetlands can be incredibly productive and critical parts of our ecosystems, both natural and corporate. So what do most organizations have? I think most organizations don't have data lakes or swamps. They have bogs or mires, which are a type of wetland where material tends to build up without producing any real growth. So in a bog or a mire, for example, a peat bog, we have a lot of material that might build up and fail to decompose on an appreciable timeline, either due to pH or due to water conditions or the type of soil. We have a situation in which stuff just collects, but nothing really grows on it. It's not broken down into valuable resources at a rate that's appreciable. There aren't organisms, plants, or animals that survive on it. And there isn't really a lot of appreciable value in an immediate sense from a bog. They have certain use cases, for example, a data preservation business, but for the most part, I don't think organizations who set out to create lakes are really happy with a bog or a mire. Instead, what I think we want to work towards is not a lake, because lakes, for the most part, are good at storing water, but per square foot or hectare of surface area, they don't necessarily create as much value. They don't unlock as many nutrients. They don't support as many organisms as, for example, marshes do. Marshes and swamps are types of wetlands where all of the nutrients that you might find in a bog, all of the data that you collect, is made available, either due to the type of soil or the pH conditions or the salinity or simply the kinds of organisms, the plants and animals that are available in the ecosystem, given the data that you have. So a marsh and a swamp vary in the sense that swamps tend to support more trees, more of these large woody perennials. And I like to think of our old-fashioned OLAP, our online analytic database systems, and our more modern but ossified BI frameworks as large woody perennials. They're good, they serve a purpose. Organizations, especially the larger they are, need to have large support structures like trees in these wetlands, but sometimes too many trees can choke out innovation. So what we might want is a combination of swamps with large mature trees, as well as marshes, where we have more annual and perennial grasses, things that are constantly recycling and adapting and changing over time. And this gives us a nice balance between tools that are production-ready tools for our organization to work from, like in a traditional data warehouse that's been productionized into actionable insights for the C-suite, but also with a portion of the ecosystem that's able to adapt, that's able to support experimentation, that has a higher level of biodiversity, for example, and that doesn't take so much effort and time to create appreciable structures, right? Cottonwoods like these and some of these red maples can take, especially given slow growing conditions around wetlands, 50 to 100 years to grow to an appreciable size. Whereas some of these sedges, perennial and annual grasses, we can have 8-foot grasses that are ready to harvest in a year. So the analogy might be a little bit stretched, but I don't think you've seen the end of it. I hope that you guys are having a better time than I am here today cleaning up our wetlands. But again, very important for your organization to nurture this kind of environment where all of the important nutrients are collected in a sink and where organisms are allowed to thrive and adapt and evolve and really convert these nutrients that might otherwise seem like waste into something valuable for our organization. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's Wednesday in the Wetlands, and we'll see you again next week.